Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel Scratch Learners. Today we are going to discuss about bubble sort. What does sorting mean? Sorting an array refers to arranging the elements of the array in some logical order. The logical order can be increasing or decreasing order of elements, right? So what is bubble sort? Bubble sort is the simplest sorting technique among all the sorting techniques. This process is based on the principle of sorting by exchange, which means we need to interchange, that is exchange, pairs of elements that are out of order until no more search pair exists. So in this process, a pair of elements are exchanged repeatedly until the array is sorted. This method is easy to understand, easy to implement, and easy to analyze. Now let's understand the bubble sort with the help of an example. So this is the array. It contains 6 elements starting from index 0 to 5. The algorithm starts by comparing the first element with the second element. An exchange will take place if the first element is greater than the second element. So here 9 is compared with 8, as 9 is greater, so we need to swap 9 and 8. So 8 will be stored here, 9 will be stored here, and all the elements will be stored in that way only. Now 9 is compared with 5, that is the element at first index is compared with the element at the second index. Okay, since 9 is greater than 5, we will again swap them. Then 9 is compared with 10. Okay, there is no need of swapping as 9 is smaller. Then we will compare 10 with 16. As 10 is smaller, we do not need to swap them. In the last, 16 is compared with 2. As 16 is greater than 2, so we need to swap them. See, this is the first pass. Okay. And see here, the largest element, that is 16, got its shorter portion. We need to sort the array in ascending order, and the largest element is stored at the last position, right? Now we will move towards pass 2, which will start again from the index 0, and it will run for first n minus 1 element. As the last element is already sorted, so we do not need to compare the second last element with the last element. Let's see how. Again, 8 is compared with 5. As 5 is smaller, so we will swap them. Now 8 is compared with 9. 8 is smaller, so we do not need to swap. In the next step, we will compare 9 with 10. Again, there is no need of swapping, right? Now we will compare 10 with 2. 10 is greater, right? So we will swap them. Now there is no need to compare 10 with 16, as 16 is already in its sorted position. So this is the pass 2. And in this step, we got the last two elements in their sorted position, right? Now in the third pass, the procedure will be repeated on first n minus 2 elements of the array, because the last two elements are already in their sorted order. So 5 is compared with 8, no need of swapping. Then 8 is compared with 9, again there is no need of swapping. Now 9 is compared with 2, we need to swap them as 9 is greater. Okay, now we will not compare 9 with 10 or 16, as they are already in their sorted order. This is pass 3, and in this pass we got the last three elements in their sorted position. Now in the fourth pass, we will compare 5 with 8, no need of swapping. Then 8 is compared with 2, we need to swap them as 8 was greater than 2. Now in the same way, we do not need to compare 8 with either of 9, 10 and 16, as these elements are already in sorted order. This is the pass 4, and in this pass the last 4 element got their shorted position. In the last pass we will compare the first 2 elements. As 5 is greater than 2, so we will swap both the elements. Now no need of comparing 5 with any other element because these are already shorted. So in this pass all the elements of the array are shorted, right? This is the pass 5. See here, there were 6 elements and we needed 5 passes for it. That means the bubble sort algorithm requires n-1 passes to sort an array with n elements. And see, in the pass 1 there were 5 steps. So in pass 1 we have 5 steps. In the pass 2 we had 4 steps. Similarly, in the pass 3 we had 3 steps. In the pass 4 we had 2 steps. In the 5th pass we had 1 step. So we can see a relation that in the kth pass there will be n minus k steps. Okay, this is the pass, this is the step, right? I hope you got my point. This is the algorithm for sorting an array A of size n in ascending order. In the first we are setting a flag variable with 0. This step is used for the loop which is executed for the total number of passes, that is n-1 times, where n is the total number of elements being sorted. This step is again a loop which is executed for total number of steps in a particular pass. For the pass 1 we needed 5 steps, for the pass 2 we needed 4 steps. Similarly, so for the kth pass we needed n-kth step, right? So this is executed for the total number of steps in a particular pass and this is equal to n-i-1. Why? I think you are simply getting that n-1 is okay, but why n-i-1 is used? Minus I is used as we know in each pass the last element already gets shorted, so there is no need of comparing the element with the last shorted elements. So that's why we are subtracting I from this to not compare with the last elements. You can also check it. For the pass 1, j equal to 0, it will run up to n-i-1. I is 1, okay? So for this example, 6-1-1, that is 4. So for j equal to 0 to 4, that means 5 times. So see here, 5 times we are repeating the pass 1, right? Similarly, for pass 2, n is 6. -i-1, I is 2, -1, that is 3. So from j equal to 0 to 3, that means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 times. So see here, in the pass 2 there are 4 steps. So for this reason we are using n-i-1. Then normally if the element at jth position is greater than the element at j plus 1th position, then we will swap both the elements. And here we are setting the flag variable with 1. We have declared it as 0 in the first, then if any swap occurs then we will set it as 1. Why? Let's understand this. Let's consider an already shorted array. If we need to sort this array, then for any specific I value there will be n loops, right? But we do not need to swap any element. So the flag will be 0 only, as we have declared flag equals to 0 in the first step. But if there be any swap, the flag value will change to 1. In this case, there will no swap, so flag will remain 0. So within the loop, we will check if flag equals to 0 then break. That means if the array is shorted before the n iterations, then we will simply come out of the loop. So I think you got my point, and this is the algorithm for bubble sort. Now we will understand the complexity analysis of bubble sort. The complexity of any sorting algorithm is analyzed through the number of comparisons required during the sorting process. In this algorithm, we can easily determine the total number of comparisons, as we have already observed that an array of size n gets sorted after n-1 passes, right? So in bubble short, for the first pass, n minus 1 comparisons takes place. We have just seen it, okay? During the second pass, n minus 2 comparison will take place. In the third pass, n minus 3 comparisons takes place. Similarly, in the kth pass, n minus k comparison take place. So after summing all these, the total number of comparisons equals to the sum of these. That will give us n into n minus 1 by 2. Thus, in big O notation, the complexity of bubble sort will be order of n square. This is the average case and the worst case complexity of bubble sort. We can simply know there were two loops for bubble sort that will run from the index 0 to approximately the last index, right? So it gives the time complexity of a bubble sort as order of n square. This is the C++ program for bubble sort in an array. We will first input the size of the array, then we will input the elements one by one by using a loop that will run from the index 0 to index n. We will store the elements in the array A at location I. Then this is the sorting part. The first step is used for the loop which is executed for the total number of passes, that is n minus 1 times, where n is the total number of elements being sorted. Okay. The second step is also a loop which is executed for total number of steps in a particular pass. That is, if we are on a pass I, then this loop will be executed n minus I minus 1 time. I have already explained this in the algorithm. So this is the same thing. And if the element at jth location of array is greater than the element at j plus 1th location of array, then we will simply swap the elements of the array at j and j plus 1th position. So by these two loops, the sorting will be completed. Then we will just display the elements of the array to check if the data are sorted or not. Now let's run this program. So let the size of array be 7. Okay. See here, I am inputting the elements in the descending order. Okay, that means the worst case. 3, 2 and 1. Just have a look, the array is sorted. Okay. So this was all about the bubble sort in array. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel. Please like and share the video with your friends. If you are having any doubt, you can also comment in the comment section. Thank you.